go. We could have used them to blow up these walls to see if there was a secret. Nope, we are not using this room whatsoever. Basically, that room, you can sacrifice yourself, your health, by standing on the spike, which, when your health is dropped to 1 heart, I believe, you, have a chest appear. Which is kind of good, I guess. Actually, you know what? Let's see if I can get something off of it. Okay, no. I thought it was if it got dropped to 1 heart, but maybe not. Okay, these guys are pretty... this beam does. You're just able to insta-kill enemies? Actually, you know what? I am going to sacrifice my health. I don't know whether this is a smart idea or not. Oh, yes, what did I get? Coins. Basically, when you're dropped to 1 heart, you're allowed to enter this challenge room, which always has an item in it. Do I want? Ugh, that's more useless. Let's go this way. Might try to clear my... gonna get another dice upgrade. Careful, careful, careful. There we go. If I take even 1 hit, I'm dead. Right now. Charge up my shot. Oh great, greed heads. I'm not actually sure that's what they're called, but it's basically what they do is if they hit you, you make some of your coins fly out. You actually permanently lose one of the coins. Okay, it's one more. I have to save my key for the item room at the moment, but if I have another key, I'll come back for this gold chest, because there's a chance there might be an item in it. Ooh, one of these. Okay, let's go back to that challenge room, see if I can get a better item. If there's a decent item from it, then I'll do it. Now, the thing with this challenge room is, sure, you get an item, but you also have to fight 3 bosses in a row. Extra health. Alright, why not? Oh, okay, so we got this guy. He basically leaps around, he fires shots, and he's got 2 different jumps. He'll do this leap, which causes shots to fly everywhere. His other jump is just a tiny little leap, which doesn't do much. Larry Jr. is easy enough, especially when you can do that. And who's the final boss? Oh, that's it. Okay, so maybe it's 2 bosses. I thought it was 3 of them, but maybe not. Okay, so I've got one of my extra hearts back. In fact, I've got my extra heart back, I should say. There's only 1 extra heart. Now, where is the item room? That's my next big question. Pretty sure it'll be down here somewhere. I want to check that out before I hit the boss. Alright, let's charge this up. Sacrifice room there. No, not sac- sorry, it's a... I'm not actually sure what to call that room. Okay, so it's gonna be pain. One more. Cool. Let's check to see what's in here. No, thank you. That item's basically like the dice, but instead of changing the permanent items, it changes the temporary items that you get. So like the hearts that are on the ground, the coin, bombs, even the troll bombs can be changed, which is kind of useful, I guess. Okay, so let's go this way, up here, charge up my shot. Just want a chance to change that arcade. Which, if I decide to go through what I want to do in the arcade, I'm probably going to be cutting out a bit of this video, because I'm sure it'll be quite boring to watch me continuously over and over gamble my money. So now, we're going to see if we can find the secret room. So there's a couple of spots it could be. Not there. Basically, the rules with the secret rooms are they're generally going to be in areas where there's two or three rooms connected to it. Not there either. Could be up here. Nope. Okay. Should be here then. In fact, this is probably the first boss I should have checked. There it is. Please don't be a boss. Good, just coins. Alright, so let's go back to the item room and change that item. I'll have to take what I can get if it doesn't come up to be anything good, because there's no other rooms in here to defeat enemies with to recharge your item. The shears. Allows you to fly for one room only, and it also causes your head to basically be decapitated from your body. please be an item. Nope, troll bombs. Cool. Alright. Let's go defeat the boss. Take a little while to get there. Wish I had more speed. That's the other thing I like to have. Basically, I like to have the Brimstone Cyclops combination. And I also like to have a lot of speed. And health, if possible. Now, this will come in handy later. I might show you that on camera. Okay, this guy. Oh, good, he's not colored. So basically, this guy jumps around. He, for lack of a better word, he pees on the ground to make that thing. And when you damage him enough, his eyes pop out of his head and start flying around the room. They're invulnerable. They cannot be destroyed at all. There we go. Basically, he's generally easy. Just gotta watch out when he jumps. And boom! Oh, another devil room. Nice. What have we got in here? Whore of Babylon. Wait, is that the Whore of Babylon? No, that's the Spirit of the Night. Now, I would get this if I didn't have Brimstone. Although, I don't know if I want to get it. Well, basically, this one here, it also grants you flight, which means rocks can no longer stop you, holes no longer stop you. You know what? I'm going to do it. So now I look like a ghost. Now this item here would be good, but I don't know if it breaks Brimstone or not. So in the older versions, it used to. Alright, so now for the fun part, we're going to the casino. What do we got here? Got this one, which doesn't give much useful things. Basically, this has a chance to give you tarot cards or explode. Cool story. Alright, so we'll go back to one of these chests, see if we can open it. Got a tarot card. Though this is not very useful for someone with Brimstone, but if you had normal tears still, this card makes it so that for the room that you're in, it allows you to, it basically makes your shots homing. Yeah, so it's basically choose the correct thing to get the item that he shows you. Hearts will be useful because, I will show in a moment. Okay, alright, last time. Oh, bombs. Excellent. I can go find the super secret. So, use this here. You get coins out of it. There's also a chance you get something called a blood bag, which increases your maximum health, and it speeds you up, if I remember correctly. Alright, let's just grab that. Try it again. That's not the one I want. Basically, with the expansion, added another item that came out called the IV bag, which is that. which is basically a usable version in your basically inventory version of that of the blood bank, which I suppose it depends on what items you have. It can be useful. There's some items you can get that give you money when you take damage, so you could essentially keep using it over and over. If that makes sense. Oh, soul heart and that. Soul hearts are useful for this as well, because the machines actually use those up first before your normal hearts. Okay, they use them up after you've used up your normal hearts. Don't use it again. So this is what I'm going to be doing for a while. See if I get something good this time. Just hoping for the blood bag, but I didn't get it this time. Nope, not this time either. Okay, take a quick break from that. Now that's right, the other thing about flying is you can actually avoid spikes as well, which is highly useful. Shit, I'm gonna get rid of this because I'm sure I'm gonna get killed by accident. So let's go down here and see what we get. Ah, troll bomb. Better put these fires out too. Okay, so while I'm down here, see if I can figure out where the super secret is. There's only one real candidate. There's no other area has only one room connected to it. It has to be here. So it is. Oh, spiders. That could have ended my run. Actually, no, I've got half health, so I'd be fine. Okay. Go back to here. No, not here. I want to go back to here. There we go, that's what I'm looking for. See, although it doesn't actually say, your speed is increased. Cool. So now, come back here, try once or twice more, and then I'll blow them up. Okay, last try. There is actually one particular power-up you can get from this guy called Pretty Fly. Don't remember what it's called exactly, but it makes you immune to flies. But I don't feel that I really need that, so goodbye. Drop some coins for me, thank you very much. You've been very helpful. So the last thing I'll do is, I'll go check out the shop for this level. And this level took way longer than it probably would have needed. But I did want that extra health maximum, because having one heart, especially on the final areas where you take a whole heart of damage instead of half. Oh good, it's greed. Of course it is. Oh, okay. And oh, this will be useful for the later levels. Basically makes it so that all shop items are 50% off. Yeah, that's what it does. Did I pick up the item in here? No, I didn't, because it was shears. I can't change it again, which is a bit of a bugger. See, now I wish I was able to afford the map. Because that actually shows you the whole level. It doesn't show you the like what the rooms are, but it does map out the whole area for you. Including the normal secret too, if I remember correctly. Alrighty. Hope this is a normal version, not an evil version. And it's the evil version. Basically, there's either the Necropolis, which is what we're in right now. Ooh, so hard. Yoink. There's another version of the room as well. What's in here? Normal, no thanks. Just go around here. Oh, bugger, I forgot about them. Ah! Now, this is the joy of being able to sit on top of these things, because enemies can't get you. If they are bound to the normal floor, while you, on the other hand, can just fly. Oh, right, I don't have a key. Let's try here. Gotta look for the secret room. There might be a key in it. These guys are a bundle of fun. Cool key. That's what I want. My item room might be here. Oh, there it is. And the Ankh. No, we'll change it. No, my little unicorn. Not even that useful. Well, it's useful because you become completely invulnerable, but bugger. The use item. So you can probably use it on bosses in like parts where it's gonna be really bad. But eh. Ooh, sweet. Any of the horsemen that you face, they will always drop, oop, careful. They will always drop a cube of meat, which is like, every time you get one, it upgrades whatever meat item you've got at the moment. So this one will become an orbiting version that can fire shots in the direction that you're facing, or shooting at. This guy's an easy enough boss, because I can just do this. Yep, that's all this version of the boss does. He just tries to follow you. I can just sit here on the rocks and pound him. Which is great. Nearly there. There we go. Cool. So, you see the cube of meat now. Boom. Now it looks like that. If I face another horseman, and he drops a cube of meat. Oh, another key. Sweet. Then instead, that orbiting cube of meat will actually turn into a guy that runs around with you and attacks enemies that are nearby. And that's useless as well. Alright, let's check in here. Spiders! Wonderful, not. So yes, you also noticed that when I flew into that door, or into the room, I didn't take any damage. Which is fairly useful. You only take damage when you fly back out. Okay, so let's check the shop. Oh, what do we got here? Tarot card. Death, that's quite useful. Basically, everyone in the room takes damage. Or even dies. Bosses won't die instantly, but normal enemies. Most of them usually... Oh boy, envy. Basically, this guy just splits continuously until his tiny heads. Those ones, to be specific. And this beam weapon just makes life so much easier. Normally you'd have to shoot the tears at him and it takes a while to go through each form. With that, cool. Let's go back to the secret room. See if I can get a better item. Dr. Fetus. What was that one? Tears become guided missiles. Sorry, if I didn't have brimstone, I would take that. Oops, I shouldn't have let go so quickly. Cool. Ah, I hate these ones. Super troll bombs follow you. Bane of E